Hi, I'm Bob Hochmuth, University of Florida IFAS Extension. I'm a regional specialized agent here at the North Florida Research and Education Center, Suwannee Valley. And this is going to be the next stop on our virtual trolley tour for our Watermelon Field Day. This segment is going to feature some of our work with degradable plastics in watermelon production. Not 100%, but nearly 100% of the acreage in Florida is grown on plastic mulch, and we call it mulch, but it really is just a thin layer of plastic that covers a little bit of a raised bed. Most of the watermelons in this area are grown with drip irrigation. When you go further south in the state, they may be grown with seepage irrigation, but up here, it's very standard to have drip irrigation under the plastic mulch. We provide the water through that drip irrigation tape. The plastic and the black plastic situation helps to warm the soils early in the spring and get the crop to harvest a little bit earlier than it would otherwise. So all of these are components that have been developed over the last few decades, really, for watermelon production. And it's a very efficient use of irrigation and also fertilizer, because we can protect the fertilizer underneath this plastic mulch and prevent or minimize leaching rain events. But in a non-degradable plastic, we have to pick this plastic up at the end of the year and dispose of it. Over the past several decades, there have been a number of different types of degradable plastics. Currently, these are degraded by microbes and other soil activity, not degraded by the sun's quite so much. So these are biodegradable types of films. Over the past couple of years, we've been working with a number of our industry partners who manufacture different types of degradable plastics. And they would include companies like Bio360, EcoPoly, Organics, and here today, Radical Plastics. So each of them have their own versions of a degradable film. They can trigger the rate of degradation for a particular crop. And so there's a lot of testing that needs to be done to have that rate of degradation fit the crop that is being grown. One of the biggest advantages for us with degradable plastics is if we can get the material to last the proper amount of time, at the end of the season, we do not have the investment in labor to go into the field to pull the plastic up. So over time, that plastic would degrade by the microbes in the soil and would be degraded into the component parts. So it's an area of research that we need to make sure that we have available to our growers degradable or non-degradable plastics that fit their particular needs. So in this case, we're able to evaluate some of the new materials as they come along and try to help the growers to be able to have confidence in the choice that they have based on the research that we're conducting here. Not only are we conducting research here at our center, but we have also been working on individual farms in the past where we would evaluate several different types of plastic on a larger scale in our growers' fields. And that's not an unusual way of doing things. We tend to do small plot research here till we find sort of what looks like it would work well, and then we would move it to a grower's field where we would upscale that on a little larger basis on a commercial farm to be able to continue the evaluation before the grower would be in a position to be forced to use it on a large scale and have something go wrong with it. So the research program helps us to help the growers make those right decisions. And this particular segment is on the different types of degradable plastics that would be used.